So, Dr. Tarek, it's a really a great, great honor to meet you, to meet the General Director of the Great Egyptian Museum, that will be the biggest, the largest museum of antiquities in the world. You are really well known. We often see you in the news, and everybody is waiting for some news of the new residence of the Pharaoh. So I will begin the question, and if there's some problem, you tell me. Of course, after the first museum in Boulak, and then the second in an old palace in Gizeh, and after the new museum in Tahrir Square, the Great Egyptian Museum is in construction in Gizeh, near the pyramid. It's really a pharaonic, a colossal construction with more than 500,000 square meters. Conceived by the Irish firm, the new Great Museum is planned to open soon. Could you tell us more about the opening or about the work now?
The work on the Grand Egyptian Museum has progressed within the last 4 years very quickly. So today we have finished all of the cement, concrete and iron works of the building. We are working on the interior and exterior finishing of the museum, and we have finished more than 60% of the interior and exterior of the museum. At the same time, simultaneously, we have done the design of the galleries of King Tutankhamun. The showcases have been ordered and are coming from two very well-known companies in Italy and Germany. And the pieces of King Tutankhamun, which will exceed 5,000 pieces, already 4,400 pieces of them have been transported to the conservation center of the Grand Egyptian Museum, and more than 3,700 pieces of them have already been restored and conserved and prepared for the new display. This is something very special, because since the discovery of the tomb of King Tutankhamun in 1922, only about 1,800 pieces from his tomb were on display. For the first time, the complete more than 5,000 pieces that were discovered inside the tomb will be on display. This will give the visitor a totally new vision of this king. It will reveal new, very interesting details about his social life, yes, the political life, the religious life, and very interestingly, the lifestyle of King Tutankhamun. Yes. What was he wearing? What was his footwear like? His jewelry? His diet? What was he eating? So actually, the Grand Egyptian Museum will reveal and introduce the man behind the gold mask.
So, Dr. Tarek, we can hope to see the opening during next year. It's possible to imagine that the museum will open?
By the end of 2018, oui, all the construction works will have finished. And the preparation for display will have started. Now there are four ministries in Egypt: the Ministry of Antiquities, the Ministry of Tourism, the Ministry of Interior, and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, all of them are working together to determine the best suitable opening date for the Grand Egyptian Museum, so that it fits the touristic schedules, and that it fits also from the whole weather conditions in Egypt. Yes. So we expect that we will have our opening within 2019, and there is strong commitment from the Egyptian government to have this opening in 2019.
2 weeks ago, the logo of the museum was presented, and the polemic started. Not enough pharaonic, not enough representative of the history. What do you personally think about the logo? And just after, the minister Khaled Al-Anani proposed to make an international competition to have a new one. What is your position about this?
Every logo in itself is a work of art. And when you have a work of art, there is always the possibility of controversial opinions about this art. Of course, this logo was done by an internationally famous designer who put into his consideration when making this logo that it should be very good as a tool of branding and of marketing. Mm-hmm. Some of the points that are in favor of this logo are that it has a point that makes it unique, because the general logo is the footprint of the museum building. So it's something special. It's the plan of the museum. It's something that is unique for this project. At the same time, the simplicity and elegance of the logo allow to use it in various ways for merchandising, for branding, for marketing of the museum. If we put this museum or this new logo between the logos of the museums of the world, the famous museums, we will find that it is positioned quite well between these logos. And none of the logos of the world, of the big museums, has anything patriotic or anything very historical to it. Most of them are now very simple and very easily to use and to recognize for branding, merchandising, and marketing. The point of having something pharaonic in the logo, none of the museums that show Egyptian collections in the world has anything pharaonic in it anymore. But of course, we are very happy that there is so much interest in this logo, and that there was so much debate about it. And for now, we will use this logo, because it's important to have a means of merchandising and of branding. And maybe at a further stage in the near future, we can then have another competition to have another logo. But this decision has not been taken yet.
Yes. Thank you. In last January, a colossal statue of a great pharaoh, Ramses II, who came from one of his temples in Memphis, arrived in the museum. The great pharaoh stay at the head of the two lands during a lot of times, but the great star of the museum will be King Tut, in fact.
Actually, of course, Tutankhamun is the golden star.
Oui.
But Ramses II is the granite star.
Yes.
So Ramses II, when you stand in front of this colossal statue,
yes,
you are captivated by it. And it is really something great that this piece was the first piece to enter the museum.
Yes.
So the largest and heaviest piece that will be shown at the Grand Egyptian Museum was the first piece to enter on
yes,
the 25th of January.
Yes.
And this is something that is really a milestone in the history of this museum. And it was a very nice sign that now the museum has been started
yes,
as a museum.
Yes.
And now the pieces will enter.
There will be inside the museum more than 100,000 artifacts from prehistoric time to Ptolemaic time. How many showrooms we will have to see? And could you tell us now how the artifacts will be in display? In clear way or in obscurity? You find at the museology, at the museography? You are thinking at this now?
50,000 pieces will be on permanent display. Another 50,000 pieces will be in accessible storage for scientific research and for temporary exhibitions. The 50,000 pieces that will be on display, 5,000 are King Tutankhamun in two huge galleries. The other 45,000 pieces, which will take us from prehistory until the Greek and Roman periods in Egypt, they will be shown in another 13 galleries. But these 13 galleries are all interconnected. So for the first time, and this will be the first museum where you can go through the historical periods from prehistory chronologically
yes,
until the Greco-Roman period within one huge area of 27,000 square meters. And the museum will move away a little from the object-oriented display to the collection-oriented display, so that you see contexts which are easily understandable.
And you imagine the context where the artifacts of Tutankhamun will be in exhibition? You know how they will be in display?
Tutankhamun, there was, when the tomb was discovered, a very big international interest
yes,
to quickly see the golden
yes,
pieces.
Yes.
So the pieces were displayed mainly to highlight the golden and gilded pieces
yes,
of King Tutankhamun.
Yes.
But at the Grand Egyptian Museum, we have done a new scenario that allows the visitor to rediscover the tomb of Tutankhamun
yes,
like Howard Carter did nearly 100 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So you are discovering the tomb of Tutankhamun with all of its content.
Yes.
You will see the pieces and you will understand how they used to be inside the tomb. You will be able to attend the funerary procession of King Tutankhamun.
Yes. We will use a lot of photos of Harry Burton, for example.
We will use some of the photos of Harry Burton,
yes,
but the pieces are the real star.
Yes, of course.
With 5,000 pieces, the archaeological artifacts are the thing that we are getting the full concentration mm-hmm. of the visitor on.
The museum is now a real enterprise with an important number of workers for the construction, and after it will be another kind of enterprise with guardian, Egyptologists, administrations, and employees in restaurants, store rooms. Do you have an idea of the number of persons who will work in this new great Egyptian museum?
We have now up to 7,000 workmen participating in the construction of this fourth pyramid of Egypt. After it opens, first estimates say that we will have more than 1,000 employees directly working in this big complex, and another 15,000 working and benefiting indirectly from this huge complex. And the real actor that will give life to this museum will, of course, be the visitor.
Yes, of course.
And we are planning that for starters, we will have up to 10,000 visitors per day, targeting Egyptians as well as foreigners.
Yes.
Because the Egyptians have to know about their history, about their roots, mm-hmm. in a new and interesting and interactive way. We have to address the young generations,
yes.
Egyptians and foreigners, in their language, which is digital and interactive.
Yes, it will be pedagogic.
Exactly.
Yes. Yes. It's a great project, really, and it's think really cleverly. Yes. So I would ask you one question about the old museum in Tahrir Square. What will stay? Some artifacts will stay in Tahrir Square in the museum, or all come here?
All the masterpieces that are related in the mind of the world mm-hmm. since over 100 years with the Tahrir Museum will remain in the Tahrir Museum, except for the collection of Tutankhamun and the collection of Queen Hatshepsut.
Okay.
Because Hatshepsut is the mother of King Khufu,
mm-hmm.
and the place of display of her collection will be directly overlooking the place of discovery,
yes. Yes.
and the pyramid of her
yes.
son. So this was such a strong connection,
yes.
that I insisted that the collection of Hatshepsut must come here. But the masterpieces, like the fantastic statue of King Khafre with the falcon,
yes, yes.
on the back of his head, the statue of King Khufu,
right,
the small one,
mm-hmm.
the beautiful statue of Rahoteb and his wife,
yes.
Nefret, the dwarf Seneb and his wife,
yes.
Ka'eber, the statue of this beautiful wooden statue, the fantastic chapel of Thutmose III with the cow, the statue of Thutmose III, the big statue of Hatshepsut, the big head of Hatshepsut, all of these pieces that have been always stars at the Tahrir Museum will remain at the Tahrir Museum. The complete collection of Akhenaton,
yes.
will remain at the Tahrir Museum. So the Tahrir Museum will remain to be a very attractive museum with masterpieces of,
yes.
ancient Egyptian art, But these pieces will get more place to breathe.
Yes, yes, I understand.
And the visitor will have more space to enjoy them and to enjoy their details.
And now that I have the answer, I can imagine that my next question is not okay, because I want to ask you about the mausoleum of Auguste Mariette. So of course he will stay in Tahrir Square.
Of course.
Yes.
And it is important that it remains there, because his work, his life achievement, is connected to that building, is connected to that collection.
Yes.
So, this mausoleum has started now to become part
of
this archaeological place.
Yes. And what could you wish deeply in your heart for the great museum?
I hope that this museum will become a forum where visitors from all around the world can come and get together with the Egyptians, especially with the young generations, that within the frame of great joint history, we can talk about a more bright future for the young generations of all around the world, that this can be a place which gives a message of peace towards the world, and that it becomes a window for Egypt, a new window for Egypt towards the world.
And just the last one question, please. What could you imagine a wonderful discovery now who can make the museum greater? Could you think about the tomb of Ankh-Senamon could be found to be with King Tut here in the museum?
I am now in the field of Egyptology since more than 25 years.
Yes.
And what I have learned is that we never cease to be surprised of what we discover in Egypt. So when last year, in February and March, we discovered more than 200 statues of Sekhmet, life-size, this is something amazing, which means that Egypt is always good for a great surprise. And should we have a fantastic discovery, like for instance the tomb of Ankhsen Pa'abat, the Grand Egyptian Museum is ready to display it, and it has the space and the possibilities to do so.
I hope it will be the case. Shukran Gilda Niamoudir.
It was my pleasure.
It was my pleasure. It was an honor for us to spend time with you. But you are very, very busy, and it was so nice to accept to see us. Thank you so much.
The pleasure.
I must say you, Forsa Saïda Aoui.
Ahna Asad. And I hope that for the grand opening of this museum, all of your viewers will honor us by their visit to celebrate together this new residence of Tutankhamun.
Yes, of course. We hope I will make an article for the inauguration too.
It will be a pleasure.
pas Kébir? Vous venez Kébir?
Yes. Il a la responsabilité de lui.
Yes. Un homme absolument chocolat, il y a à vous dire.
Nice to meet you.